Welcome to the DoubleACS Daily News. The Attleboro Council on Aging has worked with the Bristol County District Attorney's Office to collect old and unnecessary prescription drugs. There was a collection clinic at the Larson Senior Center on Friday.
Today I'm here at the Council on Aging in Attleboro, just trying to educate some seniors about safe disposal of prescription medications and certainly safe storage of prescription medications as well, especially those that are of an opiate base. We have a ton of folks who are addicted to opiates, and whether they're prescription medications or heroin or fentanyl, it's kind of taken over this country and certainly the state, and Bristol County is being hit pretty hard with the opioid crisis. And so we just want to make sure that our seniors as well as our young people are staying safe. And the best way to do that is to educate people on what they can do to remain safe. Some folks do need these medications for chronic pain management, and we understand that. And so it's just making sure that people are aware of the different things that could potentially affect someone else who is struggling with addiction, and being sure that they know that there are resources available and letting them know how to find those resources in a reasonable manner so that they can get a hold of them as soon as possible. The reason why it's really important to get these things out of the home is because a lot of young people are getting their medications or their prescription drugs from their grandparents' or their parents' medicine cabinets. And so if you're not needing the medication anymore, it's important to really just get it out of the house. You can either bring it to the police station and drop it in their disposal boxes, certainly no questions asked. A lot of the pharmacies, as like CVS, Walgreens, has the disposal boxes as well. And so you can drop them there, because prescription overdoses or just drug overdoses has been the number one killer of teens as of recent. And we just really want to try to keep it out of the hands of young people or just anybody who's struggling with a drug addiction. It's just dangerous to have in your home. And then certainly we can also avoid accidental overdoses by seniors by making sure they get out of the home. So using the med disposal bags is great. Using a lockbox if you need to keep the medications in the home. And if you don't need the medications, just bringing it to the police station or your local pharmacy to get rid of it is the best way to get it out of the home. The way that a person can reach me to schedule a presentation, whether it's for a counseling on aging or a school, you can reach me at april.m.cabrera@state.ma.us is my email, or you can certainly call me at 508-961-1983. And we have other options for school. So we have a Corey's Cause presentation that we can do for high school and middle school students. It's a presentation of a young man who struggled with addiction and now lives with a disability as a result of a bad overdose. For parents, we have the Hidden in Plain Sight mock bedroom display, which we can set up at community centers, schools, wherever we need to set that up. And it really just educates the parents on ways that they can find things that could be hidden in their child's bedroom that can indicate that they're struggling with drugs and alcohol. And then certainly I can come and do this safe disposal and safe storage of medication talks at any senior centers or regular individuals who want this information and need to know it.
That's all for today's update. You can watch all of our content by visiting our website, doubleacs.com, by checking out the DoubleACS mobile app for iOS and Android devices, or if you have a Roku, you can search for the DoubleACS Roku channel. For DoubleACS News, I'm Austin Ricketts.